Original versus Definitive, a series where I look at both versions of GTA San Andreas and see which one is better. Today we'll compare a mission called Rider, in which you talk to a rider, of course, drive him to the barber shop, get a haircut, go get yourself a pizza, escape with Rider from the angry pizza guy, and drive to Grove Street. We'll compare tasks, executions, speedrun tactics, and gameplay. Both games are completely vanilla, played on PC. I'm your host, Bad Infos, a YouTuber for 10 years. Leave a like and subscribe for more of the same. Now let's see how the mission compares between both versions. Never in your life have you guys seen Ryder's eyes in the original because of how close his glasses are to his face, but here you go! He actually has eyes in the Definitive Edition, and you can see them from time to time. In the original version, once you enter the barber shop, you'll be served by Reese himself. However, apparently in the Definitive Edition, his son takes care of you since he is at least 20 years younger in the Definitive Edition. In the original, you get a not very descriptive menu of the different haircuts you can have. In the Definitive Edition, however, each name has a small picture, so you know exactly what you're getting before selecting it. Unfortunately, selecting High Fade does nothing. CJ gets the default haircut again, and he pays $150 for it. In the original, as you see, there's a major difference. In the original, when you're looking at the pizza place, in the cutscene you notice no marker. However, in the Definitive, it is there despite it not being unlocked yet. Once again, the menu in the original is non-descriptive and also very slow, since you have to select a meal, wait for a person to change it, and then select a different one. In the Definitive Edition, however, all are listed on the screen, and you can swiftly move from one to the other. It saves time, and you get more information from the icons. Also, CJ's health, for some reason, is invisible in the menu, so you have no idea how much you need to eat to fully heal up. As for the speedrun part, you all know about the famous blowing up Ryder's car. If you do it in the original, you can skip a later lengthy cutscene, saving you lots of time. I'm happy to say that this is still present in the Definitive Edition, and it is even encouraged, since you also get an achievement if you do it. Overall, the Definitive Edition takes the cake here. The menu improvements are big, and I am all for them. It's now faster and easier to see what you're selecting. Since the rest of the mission is the same, I would say that for the second time in this series, the Definitive Edition wins this video for being the better version for this specific mission. Agree or disagree, let me know what you think in the comments below. Leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching, and a very special thank you to my top channel members and patrons: Monish Pradeep, Alex Chavez, Max Robinson, LMP Racing, How's the Chowder, Max Rich, Smokeyo, and everybody else on the screen. Become a supporter today!